I had mentioned previously how my game wouldn't crash, but OBS was crashing all the time during my live streams.
Nice to just talk a little, you and I. I was just thinking, would you be interested if I told you a little about myself? My mother may be much better at alchemy than I, but I do have one huge advantage.
Huge?
She has a lousy sense of location, whereas I never get lost. I always find the place I'm heading to. Well, sooner or later, that is.
So, where are we going now?
Oh, this map marker is floating in the air. That's where the immersive citizen AI overhaul still has a bug in it.
What is it?
After Cicero leaves, his marker never goes away. Until you actually start the Dark Brotherhood quest. So I thought I'd come by here and see if these two were alive and kicking. I told him to help Cicero fix his wagon wheel.
Garden, make room for some new plants I'm planning.
That should be all right. How much space were you planning?
Oh, half the field should do.
Half the field? What could need half the field?
I just think pollinating would be easier if I could do a lot of plants at once.
Why don't we talk about this later? Need something? All right then.
Okay, so they act like nothing happened. Nothing bad. They're both alive. I guess that's a thing now in the game. It just bugs me that map marker is still floating in the air right there. Anyway, time to kill a giant. I always screw up around here because I'm not used to this giant camp.
I think my fighting skills have improved since I met you. Don't you think so too?
There's other things here besides this giant camp. So I get confused as to what's killing me. This is sort of near an intersection where a whole lot of encounters happen. Where is the giant anyway? Maybe it was up on the hill? Where are you? Oh, there he is. Supposed to give a book or something? It's just a book. Or a weapon of some kind? Some heirloom? Something. Okay. We gotta get out of here before we all die. Metaphorically. Is that the right word? Oh. Uh-oh. Can't they kill a mammoth? What's going on? Oh, that's the wrong shell. Or wrong button I'm pushing. Kill the giant, kill the giant. Good. Swing. Oh. Whoa. Now I'm just goofing around, seeing if I can get my game to crash. Why is that giant still alive? Kill the giant. Kill it. Hit it while it's down. Don't let it get back up. Where's my other follower? They're just totally smashed into the ground, aren't they? Oh. Die! See, now the giant thinks it has to go all the way over there to get to me, because the nav mesh is crap in this location. Finally.
Now I'm gonna get you.
Okay, so all we needed was a Dremora to kill stuff. Okay, I see. Okay, we're missing somebody now. Hopefully they can come back alive if they're dead. Where are you? Are you inside a mammoth? Where are you? Because grass makes it hard to find people that are face down in the muck. Weird, where are they?
You have found a loot? Great. Let's bring it back to Wilbert then.
Oh, we came here for the loot. Oh, okay. Oh, there you are. Okay. Meanwhile, back at the Bard's College.
Welcome to the Bard's College. It's such a pleasure to see you again. Oh, you have found the music instrument. Good. As I promised, here's a reward for you. Just let me know if you want to do further tasks for the college. Welcome back. It's always a pleasure to see you. Till later.
Ah, you've returned. How goes the task I gave you? I have to admit, I didn't think it would actually be there. Now, let's take a look at this. Oh. Oh, no. This won't do at all.
That's basically all you have to do to become a bard. Let's bring back a... It's just a book! Who's playing this music? In my house. What's going on? I never heard Vilya play that song ever. Maybe I've never leveled up with her enough in the quest for her to start doing stuff like that. So I almost never do the bard's quests with her. Well, that's kind of neat.
What do you need, my Thane? Farewell.
What are you looking at? I'm not afraid of you, you know. Even if you are my elder.
What?
We done?
Why is her cloak's all turned inside out? What's going on there? Okay, Havoc. Havoc needs to be updated since the 90s, I think. Remember, who used Havoc first? Was it Quake 2?
Are you hungry? I could make a meal for you if you like.
I know Half-Life used Havoc.
So, where are we going now?
Boys, girls, how can I argue with that? Good to see you. Bye now, mister.
Oh man, she just tears off. Okay, her cape's fixed.
Ooh, wonderful. I can't wait.
And for some reason, my house Carl sleeps in this bed. I don't understand why. Ay, ay, ay. Too many sandbox mods inside the house. That's all I have to say about that. Oh, I was using the house next door to murder people so I can take their kids. I was murdering parents and then adopting the kids. But I was murdering them inside the Emperor cousin's house. Kind of cool. She never locks her house up, so I just walk into her house. Anyway. So I installed first-person view, haven't used it in about a year now, maybe 2 years. I've been using enhanced camera. Since neither of them have been updated in a couple years, I thought, you know what, okay. I'm gonna use first-person view. If it hasn't been updated, then it's probably bug-free. It doesn't need an update. So he's definitely taller than me.
Need potions? Head over to Angeline's Aromatics.
I'm just checking the height of my camera. If it alters from first to third person view. Because NPCs look at your camera when they're talking to you. And your camera's invisible. It's right in front of your face, though. And I don't see the NPC's eyes twitch all that much when I go from first to third person view. So the camera seems to stay pretty much at my eye level. Oh, we woke her up, so she's kind of not with it.
Hello, friend. Take care, dearie.
Anyway, so the bum told us to go get his shiny helmet, and I thought we'd done this, but I guess not. Or
did you hear that noise?
Removing a mod may have reset his quest, so we have to do it again? I don't know. What's her face? Braith is pretty good. With her lightning bolt staff of magic, something something, whatever. Oh, come on. Kill the other troll that's in there. Where are you going? Fine, I'll go up here and make things worse. Kill it. Kill it. Let's see you kill it. Wow, Braith is pretty good. She can stagger a troll as she sprays it with her magical lightning. Yeah, we've been here before. I'm pretty sure of it. Maybe I went back, several quests, you know how you have to, when you uninstall a mod, you have to go back to the time before that mod was installed. Maybe I did that. So history repeats itself again. Because normally I've done this quest by the time I'm level 13 or 14?
Yes?
Level 50 and I'm getting around to doing this quest. That's embarrassing.
Of course.
So the hat's always here, I guess. It's never anywhere else. Caves and forts are sort of slim pickings in the solitude area.
Anytime.
Not many dungeons in that area, because it's mostly a hill. A city next to a hill. And there's not much you can put on a hill. Maybe the person at Bethesda that was making content for the Solitude area just couldn't think of clever ways to incorporate locations in the terrain. They thought, oh, I need to have a flat area to put a fort on. I need to have a flat area to put a cave entrance to. The cave entrance needs to be near a road. Because that's how it is in Solitude. Almost all the caves are right up alongside the sidewalks. There's no private drives leading into a cave like there is in Whiterun. Whiterun has so many caves that have private drives. Private driveways going up to them. They're not just on the street, on the main drag. Someone watched too much Batman when they were a kid. Because the Batcave's right on the main drag. Near Malibu somewhere. Got your helmet again.
Divines bless you. May the ground you walk quake as you pass.
Really? You're not even gonna look at me? Let's move him towards me so he dislodge him from this pillar. Okay. Speak.
Hello, friend.
I guess better.
Look at it. That's real Nord craftsmanship, that is. Let me show you an old trick I learned as a scout. Makes it harder for the enemy to notice you. Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
So now I'm wondering what other quests I'm gonna have to redo. I'm not doing the one where you dress up in front of the Jarl. That quest doesn't really do much. There needs to be a mod called...
Whoa, what happened?
You know, maybe there is a mod for...
You know what I would found
Radiant
right now?
Raymond outfits.
Sweet role.
So there's more to the quest than what's the default has.
Shall we continue?
You have to help make the outfit. You don't just put it on and get to keep it later. No, you have to. There's more work involved.
Another corpse for the pile.
Maybe the outfit's stolen. You have to go retrieve it from somebody. You know, and it has to be worn in front of the Jarl by a certain date. Otherwise, bad things will happen. And the outfit's got a spell or a demon of some kind associated with it. So whoever wears the outfit gets possessed somehow. They're not quite the same when they're wearing the outfit. And yes, that dead guy's still in my game. He's gonna be there for a while until I turn him into an ash pile.
Good to see you again. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward. Anytime, friend.
It's always good to see someone I can count on. Good luck.
So I'm getting used to this immersive first-person view.
That was just sitting there?
I can't just turn around. I have to look. I have to actually... I have to move my body in order for my head to turn all the way around. Makes sense. Just like in real life.
Of course. Good talking to you.
Of course. Of course. All right, then.
Okay, so now she'll use her arm, I guess?
Don't
yeah.
Think about it.
To hold the lantern? It's not dark enough in here for her lantern to whip out and be used. So we'll wait until nighttime and then go outside and see if she does it. Something about if you're holding the lantern out in front of you, if you have to use a shield, then guess what happens? The lantern goes out, so you can use your shield. Am I still being followed by guards? What's this? What's this about? Okay, so she's holding the lantern now. Kind of cool. And the minute she needs to use her hand for something else, the lantern goes out.
Hello, friend.
Shh, shh.
What can I do for you?
Trouble?
Meanwhile, the guards kept telling me about vampires, so I was always paranoid that there were vampires running around. But we weren't finding any.
Be careful.
Yeah, Braith runs really slow because she's a kid, and I think the speed that you run is scaled to your height. So the shorter you are, the slower you run. I think that's how it works. So no vampires yet. I'm not powerful enough to raise anything. And Vilya won't raise anything unless there's a combat going on. So I was hoping there'd be some vampires, and then Vilya could raise this dead guy. Problem solved. He turns to ash. Eventually it did happen. He turned to ash. Meanwhile, let's go in the sewers.
Give us a quest to do.
First, let's go into the sewers, shall we?